students, welcome to the class on editorial decode, and in this class I will be decoding the crisis of Indian democracy written by Pulapre Balakrishnan. Now broadly this editorial deals with the concept of democracy. This editorial has delved deep into this concept of democracy and it has tried to reflect upon Indian democracy. Now democracy as a topic is important from GS mains examination paper 2 point of view, plus democracy per se is important for public administration and political science optional students. Now democracy in itself is an organic concept. At the face of it, just looks to be a political concept. It looks to be a concept in which the people participate in the voting process in order to elect their representatives. This is what it looks to be. But in reality, democracy is a quite complex, it is a quite organic concept. Now how it is organic? Now democracy has certain dimensions attached with it. The number one dimension, the most important dimension of democracy, is the social dimension. Now this social aspect of democracy is more important than political aspect of democracy. Now what is political aspect? Political aspect means people voting and electing their representatives. And in political aspect, again you have got the two type of division. The first type is you elect your leader once and then you try to exact episodic accountability onto the elected representatives. There is no continuous kind of accountability that is generated by the people in the first aspect of political democracy. In the second aspect, there is a continuous kind of exaction done by the people. There is a continuous type of pressure that is generated by the people in order to exact accountability and responsibility from the elected representatives. Now, when we talk about the second aspect of the political democracy, that is the continuous accountability, you need to have social democracy. Now, what is social democracy? Social democracy means you have structures, organic and inorganic community structures, which try to develop relationship in between them through social capital. So the key word here is social capital. Now what is meant by social capital? Social capital means the people indulge in such a way that they generate their links. People indulge and cooperate and coordinate in such a manner that they try to create a symphony among them. The big example of this is social audit. Another example is exacting citizen charter. Now another example is exacting right to information. Now had there been no social democracy, the people would not have been able to generate continuous kind of political democracy. So if you want to generate continuous accountability, you must build up a strong social democracy in the country. Now in India we lack this social democracy. Now how do we lack this social democracy? Now look at the various levels in the structures of the government, from the central level to the state level to the local level. Though at the local level, through 73rd and 74th constitutional amendment, we have provided certain avenues by which people can actually participate directly in the administrative and governance process. But when you look at the state level or the central level, you don't find any kind of structure existing at those levels. So the people, they remain away, they remain aloof, they remain immune, they remain repulsed from the administrative system. So if we want to have very engrossive democracy, if we want to have very substantive democracy, if we want to have very real democracy, in that case, we need to first of all strengthen this social democracy. Social democracy aati kaise hai? Social democracy ka jo basis hai, it actually lies in two other type of democracies. Now the first type of democracy is the education democracy. And the second type is the well-being democracy. Now what is meant by well-being democracy? Now well-being democracy ke aage components hai. First component is called as economic democracy. Economic democracy, and the second is the health democracy. You will participate in any kind of democratic process or work only if you will be having well-being democracy in a country. Now what is meant by well-being democracy? Well-being democracy means that the economic resources of a nation are divided equally. There is no skewedness, there is no hiatus, there is no disparity existing. There is no inequality existing in the distribution of the resources. So such kind of equitable distribution of the resources leads to the generation of a momentum and force by which people participate in this social democracy. And the social democracy again leads to the continuous type of political democracy process. So all these things are organically linked with each other. Now another is health democracy. What is meant by health democracy? Health democracy means the people having access to good primary and secondary healthcare services. Now if the people will be having good access to the healthcare services, they will be able to exert themselves onto the government to exact their accountability. They will provide feedback to the governmental structures. They will act as watchdogs against any aberration taking place. They will act as a conduit by which they will be able to provide their experience to the formalized governmental structure. Then you have got the education democracy. Now education democracy means the people have equitable access to education. And after having equitable access to education, the people also being able to utilize their education for the enrichment of democracy. Now, if you will have all these type of democracies prevalent, then it will create a situation that is generally called as egalitarianism. And in egalitarianism, you will not have a woman being raped because she will be empowered. You will have a social democracy, the people will be exerting themselves. You will be having economic democracy, the people will feel empowered. Then you have got the education democracy, again the people will feel empowered. So you will have less incidences of rape taking place, less incidences of the lower strata people being beaten up, scheduled caste and scheduled communities being beaten up. You will have less instances of people dying out of hunger. You will have less instances of people living a debilitating and poor life. So India needs to enrich its democracy, and in order to enrich democracy, we need to work on education, we need to work on health system, we need to work on generating social consensus, building social capital in the society. And once we have all this ammunition ready, only then we can participate in the political process. Because if you will be participating without this ammunition, you will be exacting on administration in an episodal manner. Kabhi kabhi aap dabaab bana paoge prashasan ke upar ki prashasan aapka kaam kar de. Jo lagataar dabaab hai, wo nahi banaya ja sakega. Agar continuous aur lagataar dabaab banana hai, to hume bahut enrich karna padega democracy ko. तभी जो पॉलिसीज है अच्छे ढंग से इंप्लीमेंट हो पाएगी, तभी अकाउंटेबिलिटी जनरेट हो पाएगी, तभी एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन एक रिस्पॉन्सिबल एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन बन पाएगी। और जो भी इंसिडेंसेस होते हैं, दलितों को मार दिया, किसी पिछड़े वर्ग को पीट दिया, तो ऐसे नहीं होंगे। क्योंकि जब आपका डेमोक्रेसी बहुत पार्टिसिपेटिव हो जाता है तो एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन ऐसी चीजें नहीं होने देता। So this was all for the tutorial decode. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is Brainy IAS. You can contact me at 845-940-000 in case you're interested in buying the video classes on entire civil services preparation. And in order to view the information of the classes, please visit my website brainyias.com. So this was all for the day. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice night.